Alright, shalom. First off, I want to start off by saying all praises, honor, and glory is due unto Yahweh, by Hashem Yahushai, by Hashem Rakakadash, the song praises who the war calls God, whose true name in the Hebrew is Yahweh, by Hashem, and in the name of Yahushai, in the name of the only begotten Son. Also, I want to say due my honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone and Peace and Mercy, to the hopeful alike, preachers of word and truth and sincerity, on the brother Taza Bond in Great Millstone, Arizona camp. Lord, well, with another video to edify. And I'm going to get right into it, man. It's Isaiah 9 and 5. It says, for every battle of the warrior is with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. You see? And this is the days we're in. The Lord is bringing a new war, a new battle of the warrior, right? And it's been prophesied that the Lord is going to be the one that brings that fire. Remember, the scriptures tell you the Lord is a consuming fire, man. We're in the time now where you got men sitting there telling you that the mark of the beast isn't what it is, right? You got men questioning the doctrine with nothing to, you know, fill in. But at the end of the day, if you take this devil shit, right? If you take that mark, right? You will be destroyed. You will be destroyed. And the Lord's going to do all this. The Lord's going to burn filth off the face of the earth. And he's going to burn our enemies off the face of the earth. And you so-called white people who are Esau, Edom. Right? You're going to be the chief ones that are going to be tossed into that fire. A great number of you. A great number of you. And the others that aren't, you will go into captivity under the Israelites. This is Deuteronomy 32. In 41, and it says, if I wet my glittering sword, and what is the glittering sword? Really? Like, you got to think about this. Remember, the Lord is a supreme being. You know, you think the Lord is going to come down with just a knife that man makes? No, the Lord has his own weapons. The scriptures tell you that the Lord created the smith that blows the coals and the fire, so he has his own weapons. He made men on the face of the earth today to make weapons that will be used for his work, his service. It says, if I wet my glittering sword and my hand take hold of judgment, I will render vengeance to my enemies and I will reward them that hate me. And who has hated the Lord? The heathen, man. All the heathen. Right? They said, come and let us cut them off from being a people. They directly made a declaration of war against the Heavenly Father when they came against Israel. In the way and fashion that they did under Esau, Edom. Verse 42, it says, I will make my arrows drunk with blood, and my sword shall devour flesh. Now, does a regular sword devour flesh? Remember, devour basically means to consume, to, you know, dissolve away. Right? So can a regular sword do that? It says, and that with the blood of the slain of the captives from the beginning of revenges upon my enemies. Rejoice, O you nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants, and will render vengeance to his adversaries, and will be merciful unto his land and to his people. So the Lord said, his sword is going to devour flesh, and his arrows shall be drunk with blood, because the Lord is going to consume flesh off the face of the earth, and it's going to be all through what? The ICBM missiles, all this military weaponry that's being made, all these advancements to all these countries' missile systems and missile defense system, this is all for the service of the Lord. The Lord said what? He had opened. Let me get it. Jeremiah 15:25, it says, Yahweh had opened its armory and brought forth the weapons of his indignation, for this is the work of Yahweh of hosts in the land of the Chaldees. You see, So the Lord has opened his army. The Lord is, the scriptures tell you, sword is sharpened, the sword is sharpened, right? So all these missiles throughout the world, the Lord put it on men to make these for his purpose, just like he raised up Pharaoh for his purpose, just like he raised up all the kings of the earth for his purpose. He had raised up these scientists, all these men of war, all these artificers, right? The men that mold these weapons, the Lord gave them that inspiration because what? He had a work to do in these days where he said he was going to have his sword to devour all flesh, right? And we read the scripture where it talked about the Lord had that glittering, bright and glittering sword, right? Let me go up on this Jeremiah 50 and sort of 8, it says, remove out of the midst of Babylon and go forth out of the land of the Chaldeans, and be as the he goes before the flocks. For lo, I will rise and cause to come up against Babylon an assembly of great nations. And you're seeing that now. You got China, Russia doing joint military drills. You got Syria, Afghanistan, Iran, all teaming up together, right? All the stage is being set for what? World War III, and that's that assembly of great nations, because all these nations, even the allies of Esau, even the so-called white men in America, right? Because this is the whore that rides the beast. The beast is talking about NATO and the EU, right? All those Edomite nations are going to turn against America. It says, below I will rise and cause to come up against Babylon, which Babylon means what? Confusion. And America is that place of great confusion. An assembly of great nations from the north country, and they shall set themselves in array against her. From thence she shall be taken. Their arrows shall be as a mighty expert man. Now shall we return her with vain. And now these arrows that it's speaking about, it's not talking about a bow and arrow, right? Arrows don't devour flesh. The scriptures talk about an arrow that devours flesh as well. It says, and Chaldea shall be a spoil. All that spoiler shall be satisfied, say Yahweh, because you were glad, because you rejoiced, O you destroyers of mine heritage. Esau, Edom is extremely glad to see Jake down at the bottom. Look at his history. He's just like what is the holiday, the heathen day, Thanksgiving, right? That whole holiday, the fact that people eat all the same meals, the turkey, the cranberry sauce, right? All that goes back to a resemblance of the sacrifice and the slaughter of the Native Americans. These devils make holidays off of the destruction of Jake. So it says, we read it again, it says, verse 11, because you were glad, because you rejoiced, O you destroyers of my heritage, because you have grown fat as the heifer at grass and bellow as bulls, and America is fully fat. It says, verse 12, it says, your mother shall be sore confounded. Talking about what? Who's the mother of America? Great Britain, right? Your mother shall be sore confounded. She that bare you shall be ashamed. Behold, the hindermost of the nations shall be a wilderness and a dry land. It says, verse 13, because of the wrath of Yahweh, it shall not be inhabited, right? Because what? The Lord said what? He's going to, when you go back to Isaiah 66 and 15, how does the Lord plead with flesh? By fire. So this is why this is why you know, the whole of America is going to be as a wilderness. So verse 13 again, it says, because of the wrath of Yahweh, it shall not be inhabited, but shall be wholly desolate. Everyone that goeth by Babylon shall be astonished and hiss at his plagues, right? Because when you go into the scriptures, it tells you this place is going to be the dwelling place of doleful creatures and evil spirits, man. Right? Because this is going to be nothing but a desert. The Lord said there was going to be a day that all the elements shall melt as a fervent heat, with a fervent heat. Right? And that place where that lake of fire that the scriptures talk about, remember, a lake is a small body of water. So people that try to act like the entire world is going to be burnt up. Really, you need to go back to the definition of what lakes are. America is going to be that pit of that lake, that burning fire, man. It says, everyone that go by Babylon should be astonished and hiss at all her plagues. Put yourself in array against Babylon round about, all ye that bend the bow, shoot at her, spare no arrows, for she had sinned against Yahweh. And that's exactly what America's done. And I even saw an article yesterday, I believe, where this damn elementary school teacher tugged down, which fucked the American flag, but she tugged down the American flag and put up a gay pride flag and told the kids to come and join her and pledge an allegiance to a pride flag. Pledging allegiance to a debaucherous as representation of what the Lord has set up as an atonement for peace, that the world wouldn't be flooded again. You see, this is why America has to be burnt up. So all the works are corrupt. It says, a shout against her roundabout. She had given her hand. Her foundations are fallen. Her walls are thrown down, for this is the vengeance of Yahweh. Take vengeance upon her, as she had done, do unto her. You see? And this is what's going to happen. The Lord is going to sit here and take vengeance against America through all these nations, man. Remember, the Lord ain't nothing to play with. And America has promoted what? Destruction and ill behavior throughout the entire world. So what the Lord said, he's going to break this place up. This is, I'm going to jump down to 23. It says, how is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? And who was the hammer of the earth? The scriptures talk about a nation that beat the people with a continual stroke. Who did that throughout the entire world? America. No other nation has been so prevalent in doing it. How is the hammer of the earth, whole earth, cut asunder and broken? How has Babylon become a desolation among the nations? I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon. It says, when we read in this, man, you can change that Babylon up for America every time. It says, and thou wast not aware, thou art found, and also caught, because thou hast striven against Yahweh. Yahweh had opened his armory, and had brought forth the weapons of his indignation. For this is the work of Yahweh of hosts in the land of Chaldeans. You see, the Lord has opened his armory and brought forth the weapons of his indignation, because this is the work of the Lord. Right? So there's not going to be any confusion of how America's getting destroyed like it is. This was the work of the Heavenly Father. He wanted this. Right? Verse, where are we at? 26, it says, come against her. From the uttermost border, open her storehouses, cast her up as heaps, meaning rightful booty's hole, right? And destroy her utterly, let nothing of her be left. And how is this going to be done? What else can you think of that can completely consume everything? It's a fire. The scriptures talk about a beast of destruction, right? It says, slay all her bulwarks, her bullocks, let them go down to the slaughter. Woe unto them, for the day is come. The time of their visitation. It says, verse 28, it says, the voice of them that flee and escape out of the land of Babylon to declare in Zion the vengeance of Yahweh, our power, right? Where are the voices of those that escape, that fleed out of Babylon? Because it's not about leaving this place carnally, it's about leaving this place spiritually, right? That's why it tells you, come out of here, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, receive none of her plagues. This plague that's coming is this fire, right? To declare in Zion the vengeance of Yahweh, our power, the vengeance of his temple, right? And we're the ones declaring the vengeance of the Lord, the vengeance of his temple. We're the ones telling you this is what the Lord is about to do. Nobody else is talking about America like this but the Israelites, man. And the ones that are doing the most fervent are the men of great millstone, and the ones that hold on to the doctrine and follow the orders of the men that are in it. It says, verse 29, it says, call together the archers against Babylon, all ye that bend the bow. And who are the archers? All these other nations that have these missile capabilities. All these nations, man. Why do you think more and more information is coming out about new missile systems throughout all these countries? It's because the Lord is preparing this. It says, all ye that bend the bow, camp against it round about, let none thereof escape, recompense her according to her work, and according to all that she had done, do unto her. For she have been proud against Yahweh and against the Holy One of Israel. And how does this place show pride against the Lord, right? You set up laws that are contrary to the Heavenly Father. You push forth a Vanessa mandate where everybody has to get, you know, shot up and armed and get your concoction in them for them to be even able to go about their business, when that's making a cut in the flesh, which is against the Heavenly Father's word, right? And pretty soon they're about to come against the men of the Lord, all Israel, and that's pride, and they think that they're going to succeed, right? It says, verse 30, it says, therefore, her young men shall fall on the streets, and all her men of war shall be cut off in the day of Yahweh. In that day, said Yahweh, behold, I am against thee, O thou most proud, say Yahweh host, for thy day is come, the time that I will visit thee. You see, this is what the Lord got prepared for you devils, man. You see? And that fire is coming, man. The Lord has fully got all these nations capable. Man, hey, with this whole shutdown, them sitting there saying that there's all these shortages of chips, what do you think these nations are doing with it? What do you think these nations are doing with those resources? They're no longer putting it into, agricultural needs and all that. They're what, like the scriptures say, beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears, meaning that they're getting militarily strong right now, right? They're not worried about, you know, producing masses of cars and shit like that. They're worried about producing masses of military-grade equipment, right? This is, Joel 2. And 1. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let the inhabitants of the land tremble. It says, for the day of Yahweh cometh, for it is at hand. And what is the day of the Lord? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light, even great darkness. And no light in it, right? Meaning it's going to be all out hell. It says a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, and a great people and a strong. There had not been ever the like, neither shall there be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. You see, this is what the Lord is preparing in the same time. These men and these people that it's talking about is not talking about regular men. It's not taught. This is an allegory. Right? When the prophet Joel saw this, he saw this as a great army, right? This is verse 3. It says, a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burning. What is the fire that devours before and the flame that burns behind? It's going into the warhead, which is before, and the flame that burns behind, which is the propulsion system, the thrusters, right? It says, the land is at the Garden of Eden before. Now, if this was regular men, how is a man? How is this going to be possible? It says the land is as the Garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yeah, and nothing shall escape. Right? When have you ever been able to literally pinpoint a time where men can sweep across the earth in such a short duration, and behind them is just complete destruction, like an extreme wilderness, a straight desert is left. It never happens. It says the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen, so shall they run. It's going into the missiles, man. This is exactly what it's talking about, the missiles. It's going to come like a great army, and it's going to make a normal, healthy land into a barren wilderness. It says, so shall they run, man. And horses represent power. Right? It says, like the noise of chariots on the tops of mountains, they shall leap. And what is that going? That leap going into? It's going into what? It's going into how the missiles, right, do that arcing fashion. That's that leap, because it's called an intercontinental ballistic missile. It starts at the delivery base, goes up into orbit, detaches, and it comes back down. That's that leaping. And then all you get is boom, you know? So it says, like the noise of chariots upon the tops of mountains, shall they leap, like the noise of a flame of fire that devoureth the stubble, and is a strong people set in battle array. Right? This is what's being prepared. You can't get out of this. You cannot get out of this. This is what the Lord said would happen. It says, before their face, the people shall be much pained. All faces shall gather blackness, because a lot of these missile systems, a lot of these new missiles are hypersonic, man. They're talking about from Russia to America, it can take no more than 20 minutes. No more than 20 minutes for a missile to get from Russia to America. Right? Imagine how much fear and dread are going to fall on people's faces when they hear those sirens. They get those text alerts sitting there telling them that this is it. It says, they shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war. Right? Because they're going up and they're coming down to kill. It says, they shall march every one on his way, and they shall not break their ranks, man, just like men of war. These missile defense systems can hit shit directly. When they say they want to hit at this longitude and this latitude, at this angle, with this force, these missiles have all the technology to do that, because the Lord said, a sword is sharpened to make a sword slaughter. Right? The Lord made them perfect these weapons to make this happen. It says, neither shall one thrust in another. It says, they shall walk everyone in his paths, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. Now, if something's going to hypersonic, something's breaking the sound barrier, how much it takes time to build up speed to block something like that, and nothing in this world is being made to be able to do that, right? So when these things shoot off, the scriptures tell you the plagues are shot like as a mighty extra man and shall not return. So this is it. When this stuff goes off, this is it. America is through, and the kingdom of heaven is thereafter. It says, verse 8, it says, neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk everyone on his paths, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. They shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run up upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter into the windows like a thief. The earth shall quake before them. The heavens shall tremble. The sun and the moon shall be dark. And the stars shall withdraw their shining. You see? When that mushroom cloud comes up, that nuclear cloud, hey, it's going to be pitch black out there in this world, man. It says, Yahweh shall utter his voice before his army. You see, this is an army of the Lord. For his camp is very great. For he is strong that executed his word. For the day of Yahweh is great and very terrible. Who can abide it? You see? And this is how crucial the judgment of the Lord is going to come against America. The Lord is done with this place. America, at this point, America has served its purpose to be the last captivity of the children of Israel, and to punish us and promote wickedness throughout the world. And now that time is up. Next is the Lord fulfilling his judgment on his place. This is 2 Esdras 15 and 37. It says, and there shall be a great fearfulness and trembling upon earth. It says, they that see the wrath shall be afraid, and trembling shall come upon them. Then shall there come great storms from the south and from the north, and another part from the west. And strong winds shall arise from the east, and shall open it. It says, and the cloud which he raised up in wrath, and the star stirred cause fear, right? That star that stirred it to cause fear is talking about the missiles towards the east and the west shall be destroyed. It says, and in great clouds, it says, in great and mighty clouds shall be puffed full of wrath and the star. It says, that they may make all the earth afraid in them that dwell therein, and they shall pour out over every high and eminent place a horrible star, fire and hell and flying swords and many waters, that all fields may be full, and and all rivers with the abundance of great waters. You see, the Lord is getting ready to kill a lot of fucking people. That horrible star on every imminent place, the flying swords, it's all talking about the missiles, man. Right? This is Revelation 16, or Revelation 9, sorry. Revelation 9 and 16. And it says, and the number of the army, the horsemen, were 200,000, right? 200 million, that's what that 1,000,000, when you multiply it, it says, and I heard the number of them, and I saw, as, you know, horses and horsemen represent power, right? It says, and thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them having breastplates of fire going into the body of the missile. A fire in Janus and brimstone. That sounds like a missile. In the heads of them, of the horses, in the heads of the horses, whereas the heads of lions, meaning when you talk about a head of lion, that's where the fear comes from, because it has that, has those teeth, and out of his mouth issued fire and brimstone, right? Those, that goes into that the nuclear warhead within the missile. And by these three was the, and it says, and by these three was the third part of man killed, going into Esau, Edom, right? And the wicked, because it has the sons of the wicked, the sons of the heathen, or the nations, and the sons of God. Those are the three definitions of men in the scriptures. It says, by these three was the third part of man killed. It says, by fire, and by the smoke, and by the brimstone, which issued out of their mouths. For their power is in their mouth and in their tails. What is the power in their mouth? The nuclear warheads? The power that's in their tails is the propulsion system. For their tails were like unto serpents, and had, it says, and had heads, and with them they do hurt. You see? Now let me get this. This is Zechariah. I need on this, because hey, this fire is meant for a reason, because all these missiles were created to fulfill this scripture, and this hasn't happened yet. Zechariah 14 and 12. It says, and this shall be the plague wherewith, highlighted. And this shall be the plague wherewith Yahweh will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem. Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet. And what in the world now has this capability? You have to ask these questions. It says their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth. That nuclear fire causes that, because the scriptures tell you all elements shall melt with a fervent heat, right? And the human body is made up of all elements. It says, and it shall come to pass in that day that the great tumult from Yahweh shall be among them, and they shall lay hold everyone upon his neighbor, and in his hand shall rise up against the hand of his neighbor. You see, this is what's going to happen. That great destroying wind that the scriptures talk about is talking about these nuclear missiles hitting, and this is the time we're coming into, right? I'm going to end it by playing this video. This is still one of my favorite videos.
Yahweh!
Yahweh!
Ba'ashem!
Ba'ashem!
Yahweh Shai!
Yahweh Shai!
Shalom!
Shalom!
Mawaf!
Mawaf!
Wah!
Wah!
Rayam!
Rayam!
Wah!
Wah!
Ainashu!
Ainashu!
Wah!
Wah!
Aragim!
Aragim!
Wah!
Wah!
Abagim!
Abagim!
Al!
Al!
Kal!
Kal!
Adawamyam!
Adawamyam!
Wah!
Wah!
Gawayam!
Gawayam!
Wah!
Wah!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Baba Kusha!
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 Yahweh!
Yahweh!
Ba'ashem!
Ba'ashem!
Yahweh Shai!
Yahweh Shai!
Shalat!
Shalat!
Rayam!
Rayam!
Wah!
Wah!
Ainashu!
Ainashu!
Wah!
Wah!
Mashapatyam!
Mashapatyam!
Wah!
Wah!
Aragim!
Aragim!
Wah!
Wah!
Abagim!
Abagim!
Wah!
Wah!
Mawafyam!
Mawafyam!
Wah!
Wah!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Wah!
Wah!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Abad!
Abad!
Baba!
Baba!
Yahweh!
Yahweh!
Ba'ashem!
Ba'ashem!
Yahweh Shai!
Yahweh Shai!
Shalom!
Shalom!
Rayam!
Rayam!
Wah! Babakushan!
Babakushan!
The water!
The water!
Amun!
Amun!